16 miles an hour, decreasing tonight, becoming easterly tomorrow.
He has the blood, and there never was a horse like the Tennessee Stud.
Oh, man.
Santa called his elves together to soup up his old sleigh, so Rudolph and the other reindeer could rest on Christmas Day. He's got a million miles to travel and to do it in one day. Oh, that's because old Santa Claus has a souped-up Santa
Get you some help.
No, doctor.
Yeah, there's a town about 3 miles up the road. Yeah.
No.
That heater to work.
No, it's okay.
It ain't okay. It ain't okay. Here. Oh, come on, man. You'll be all right.
Town none too soon.
No doctors.
Well, I ain't got a doctor at heart. I just got a public health nurse.
No nurses.
You don't like nurses either?
No, I don't.
Right.
I'm not going to Arden.
Okay, take it easy. Where are you going?
I'm going to Vegas.
You are, huh? You know, if you don't beat all, strange old weirdo wino laying out in the middle of the desert, everybody driving by, nobody's even seeing you. I pick you up, I put you in my truck, I'm taking you where it's safe, and what do? You give me a hard time, you rag me, you bug me.
No stops, please.
Going home to Gabs.
What are you doing, Gabs?
Well, I work in a plant, magnesium plant. You know, I've had a lot of jobs, but I can't seem to get the right one, you know? When I was a milkman, I used to go around and see these wives would be at home and their husbands would be out working graveyard, night shift. And I thought about that and said, maybe I should do that. So I went around and I applied for a job at a place like McDonnell Douglas, Northrop Hughes.
Well, what happened there?
They didn't want me.
What a shame.
How come you keep saying that? What a shame.
Well, I might have done something.
Like what?
I'm Howard Hughes.
Well, you know, listen, I believe anybody can call themselves whatever they want. I got this stuff from my sister who put it in my trailer.
What'd you say your name was?
Dumar. Melvin. First name.
You're kidding me, Melvin.
Hey, listen, buddy.
Yeah.
You want to do me a favor?
Depends on what it is.
Well, I see. I wrote this song.
No.
It's a Christmas song. You like it. It's called Santa's Souped Up Sleigh.
Oh, God.
See, what I did was I had to wrote the words, and then I sent the words into Hollywood Music Company. They make the music up for you. It costs $70, but it's worth it. Here's how it goes. You want to hear it?
No, I don't.
Santa called his elves together to soup up his old sleigh. So Rudolph and the other reindeer could rest on Christmas Day. It's got a million miles to travel and to do it in one day. And that's why Santa Claus has a souped-up Santa sleigh.
Enough, sir.
Come on, you haven't heard the good part yet. This dramatic narration, it's like Red Sovine. Hey, up there, Batman, what are you doing on my roof? Why, I don't care if you're Santa Claus.
Please stop.
What's the matter?
My ear.
I told you we should have stopped back there.
It's the sound.
What do you mean?
Your song.
Well, you can be cruel, you know that? Did anybody ever tell you that? You can be real cruel.
I have an aversion to song.
That's what makes you an old asshole. Now just sing along with me. This is the chorus. It's got a rocket burning mighty quick, turning souped up Santa's sleigh. Comes in like a streak of light and it goes out the same way. You got it?
No, I don't know.
Listen, man, you sing this or you walk. Okay? He's got a rocket burning mighty quick, turn souped up Santa's sleigh. He's got a rocket burning mighty quick, turn souped up Santa's sleigh. You got it, you're getting it, you're getting it. Okay, one more time. He's got a rocket burning mighty quick, turn souped up Santa's sleigh. Hey now, fat man, I told you to get off my roof. That chimney's too small, and you're gonna fall. Come on down off that roof. Now, this is the last verse. When you hear that rocket roar, you know Santa's on his way. Okay, you ready?
When you hear that rocket roar, you know Santa's on his way.
But he'll be back again next year in a souped-up Santa sleigh.
But he'll be back again next year in a souped-up Santa sleigh.
Hey, that's great, man. Hey, you know what?
What?
You sounded good.
Come on.
You did. Didn't anybody ever tell you to sing?
No.
Huh. Come on, let's hear one of yours.
I don't know any songs.
Oh, come on. You must know one. How about... do anything. Do Love Me Tender, Don't Be Cruel, my woman, my wife, anything.
I don't know any songs. My father was a singer in the family. I played the saxophone. When the sunset turns the ocean blue to gold. Bill Bailey. He'd say, Sonny, you do the verse and I'll take the chorus. And off he'd go.
Well, I mean, do you know any song?
Bye Bye Blackbird.
There you go. There you go. Oh, sorry. Lay it on me, old-timer.
Aunt, don't be crazy.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's been a great show, and now we have a special attraction, an old-timer with a new song. Now, he's been strumming and playing all his life, so let's hear it for the old-timer and Bye Bye Blackbird. Take it. Come on, sing it. That's nice. That's real nice, but I don't think I heard any words. Any words?
Pack up all my cares and woe. Here I go, singing low. Bye-bye, blackbird, where somebody waits for me. Sugar sweet, so is she. Bye bye, blackbird. No one here can love or understand me. Oh, what hard luck stories they all end me. So make my bed and light the light. I'll be home late tonight. Blackbird.
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 Bye
bye.
Priestley.
Sage.
Nothing like the smell of the desert after the rain.
Priestley and Sage. In the kitchen or something?
How do you get out of this thing?
Oh, yes.
Hey.
Well, I had a good time, but
yeah.
Oh, sorry. Look, you better take care of that arm.
You got any money?
Well, here's something else. That's it. That's all I got. Take care of yourself, will you?
Thank you, Mel.
Okay.
Made. fucking nights this week. Go to sleep.
Linda!
Mom, what's going on? Please get over.
Hey,
where are we going? Where are we going?
Hey! Linda!
Come on, Dad! You
said
no strings attached!
You said no strings attached! I didn't say no.
Friends deserve each other.
How are we gonna pay for this?
Do the job.
What job? Oh, I don't know. I guess. I don't know.
Oh, the job.
I think I wanna go home.
I can't go home.
I miss my friends.
And Daddy?
Yeah, I miss him.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Making all local connections bound for Las Vegas. Stopping at Sparks, Stillwater, Bathurst.
Did you get it?
Yeah.
Gabs.
Come on, let's make sure something to eat. Hey, mister. Got a knife?
Yeah.
Tracy, go get the knife.
Don't cut yourself with the knife, okay? Thank you.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Hand me that plate right up there, Darcy. Hurry up. Go get some mustard.
But when you get to Gabs, be sure and get off, all right? Okay, and don't get off before then. If anybody talks to you, anybody suspicious, just don't talk back. Just move right to yours and catch up.
Yeah.
We broke it. Go right up and talk to the driver. Now I want you to tell Nell and Morris hello.
Is everything okay over there?
Everything's just fine. Thank you very much.
For the Las Vegas bus. Final call for Las Vegas.
That's you.
Thank you. Mel. What are you talking about? Moping around like a baby. Linda'll be back.
Yeah?
They always come back.
Huh.
Take me, I can't stand my wife. But I always go back. I'm going back this weekend. You wanna come?
See your wife?
I got a sister.
Yeah? What's she like?
Oh, tall, thin, bluish hair. She takes the tolls on the Golden Gate Bridge. You'd like her.
Yeah.
You wanna come, Melvin?
I'll tell you what, though. I'll ride with you to Reno. How's that? Okay? Yeah.
How you gonna find Linda, Mel?
Darcy told me where she's been staying.
Here you go, Mel.
Aw, man, get rid of that. Put that away.
Sure, good, Mel.
With you. Don't want to argue with you. I'm complying with the law. That's your official notification of an interlocutory decree. It'll be final in 6 weeks.
Oh.
That. Keep your ring if you want.
Wait a minute, Melvin! Melvin! You wait! What does it say about Darcy in here?
I get custody, that's what.
What do you mean you get custody?
What do you think? I want her being around a weird place like this?
No, oh, Melvin! God damn it!
Now take it easy, pal.
Andy, go!
Right. Hey!
Leave.
Make sure he doesn't come back. Hey, look, Linda, I'm sorry, but I can't accept this.
Oh, never mind. Quit.
That's great. Thanks, Linda.
You've enjoyed the
It's a bummer since we've parted. We have had so much we could look forward to. Like getting drunk and petty till our necks were blotchy red. Then watch TV and pass out at nearly two.
Where's the butter? Put them on. Put them on.
Okay, Rocky, what do you think? $500, not bad, eh?
I want to go for the gate.
Oh, you want to go for the gate? Oh, well, then you'll have to kiss this little Checky Wacky goodbye. Oh, goodbye, Mr. Checky Wacky. There he goes. Welcome to Mr. Pocket. Okay. Now tell me, Rocky. Listen, which gate would you like to go through? Number one? Number two?
Gate number two.
Three.
Three.
Okay, gorgeous guardians of Easy Street, it's gate number three.
Well, hey, I told you, didn't I? Did I tell you what?
To provide Rocky with interesting subjects for her new Yashica, a trip to Hawaii on United Airlines. United, a friendly airline.
Thanks.
What for? Well, honey, that's great. They're going to go to Hawaii. They're going to fly under friendly skies. They're going to lie in the sun. You should be happy for him. See, look. Look at Wally talking to her. See her smile?
Now go on, play.
Yeah, turn off the TV. Hello.
Hello, Melvin.
Well, hey, Lynn, how's it going?
How's what going?
Got going.
Could Darcy come down and see me?
Are you drunk?
No, I'm not drunk.
Are you pregnant?
What do you mean, am I pregnant? What do you want to ask me a thing like that for?
Well, how pregnant are you, anyway?
I'll tell you what. For your sake, you better hope it's a girl.
What are you talking about, Melvin?
You know what I'm talking about. I'm telling you that if that's a
thank
boy,
you, Mom.
And it doesn't look like me, you're in big trouble. You're both in trouble.
I just want to see Darcy.
Well, listen, why don't you come out here?
Where?
Vegas.
Come on out to Vegas. We'll do it in Vegas. I'll marry you there.
What do you want to marry me for, Melvin? You just divorced me.
Because I want to. That's all. I just want to. Right?
Melvin?
Yeah?
I've been reading this book called The Magic of Believing.
Yeah, what's that?
It's about you.
Oh, right.
It says that you can be anything that you want to be, but you just have to believe in yourself. And you believe in yourself. It's just that the believing has not been enough to let you become what you believe that you can be.
Well, you know, they didn't burn down Rome in one day. You've got to keep plugging.
Well, I've been thinking. I haven't been very good to you. I haven't believed in you like you believe in you.
Well, how about this? How's computer programming sound? I've been reading this book about it.
Computer programming? Real estate? Insurance? Anything but bag and magnesium?
Yeah.
You really want to marry me again, Melvin?
I've been missing you. How about it?
Hurry up, Art. It's a disinfectant. How do I look?
Fat.
I do, don't I?
But nice. You look real good.
Really?
Yeah.
Promise?
Yes.
Okay. Really?
Yeah, you look real good.
Hey, your dress looks good.
Oh, really?
Hey, Linda, looks like you guys are getting married just in time.
Shut up, Fred.
Sit.
Look out. Married again.
Hi, we're the Dumars, the Dumar family.
Not yet, you're the Dumars.
Oh, yes, we are. We're just getting married again.
Would you like a veil?
Oh, yeah. How much are they?
$5.
No,
we'll
really
take one.
No.
Yes.
Well,
yes.
Ma'am, then $5.
Yes.
Well, I will have a veil. But I want a blue one to match my suit.
Good.
Nice, huh?
Yeah.
Wow.
Ready.
Mm-hmm. And on the music.
Oh, yeah, what do you have?
Well, I got inspirational, because, Hawaiian, the war chant.
War chant.
Because.
War chant.
War chant.
War chant.
Hawaiian war chant.
All right.
Very good. That'll be $5 on the veil, $5 on the music, $15 on the ceremony, $4 on the license, and $10 on the witnesses. That's $39 all together. The Dumars.
Yeah.
All right, that's 39 at 40. Thank you.
It doesn't leave us much for breakfast, does it? Well, see, I didn't count on the witnesses. Yeah, witnesses.
Well, they gotta eat too, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Right this way.
Yeah.
Well, Milton, I'm palpitating.
Part.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part. Till death do us part. Linda, Elvin, I now pronounce you man and wife.
Well, this is it, Melvin.
Yeah.
Nice. Real nice.
$2.25 this time, Bonnie.
Really?
$2.25 is right.
See? I'm gonna win that TV. I'm gonna be the milkman of the month.
Well, you're in the lead, Melvin. You wanna know something? I'm looking for you.
Are you married, Doug?
Hey, Melvin. Listen, I wanted to tell you. You're doing a real good job.
Well, thank you.
Only thing is, hey, Harry, you remember that engine you blowed up your first week? Now, fellas, I was talking to Mr. Rockwood about it. Now, the only thing we can figure out to do is deduct.
What?
Look, we take it real slow. Take it real easy. A few dollars a week, you won't even feel it.
Listen, that wasn't even my fault. That truck was a piece of junk when you gave it to me.
You signed a note, Melvin.
Don't you know I'm on the top of the list to win the Zenith 190K with a triple scope screen?
Look, Melvin, what can I tell you? You know we base Milkman of the Month on the net. And with these deductions coming up, I don't see how you're even going to be in the running.
Nah, that's my TV, you understand? That's for my wife and my kid, and I'm going to be the Milkman of the Month.
Let go, Melvin! Look, you let go. You don't come back here tomorrow.
what about it, huh? Come on, am I the milkman of the month or not?
Yeah, you're the milkman of the month.
Get the TV set, too?
Yeah, you get the set.
Go ahead and deduct whatever you want.
Repossessed the car today.
These guys are gonna stick together.
Did you hear me?
Yeah, I heard you.
Right in the parking lot outside Kmart.
That's alright.
Sure.
What's for supper tonight?
Bell peppers.
Lenny, you know I don't like bell peppers. Bell peppers. I don't like them.
I got bell peppers.
Shh! It's the gateway to Easy Street. Gate number two.
It's gonna be one.
Two.
Number three.
Come on, two.
Three. Number two.
Come on,
two.
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 One.
Two.
Number two.
Two.
See? Every time. When you get up there to the gateway, just keep betting up. Bet up, okay? Come on. Don't settle for nothing.
But now, suppose we're ahead a few $100. My God, think what we could do with a few $100.
Hey, how about try a few thousand on the side? We could be in Hawaii with cash inside. Don't worry about it. Just be brave, baby.
Baby?
Yeah. This is show business.
Gentlemen, the star of Easy Street, Wally, Mr. Love Williams.
Hey! Oh. Don't stop, keep that love coming in. Okay, then you know how it works, and I won't bother you with all those silly rules and everything. Love is what it's all about. We have acts, you judge them. If they go back to squalor and poverty row, it's your fault, not mine. But if you love them, they go on maybe to fame and fortune. Anyway, that's what the show's all about, love. So without any further ado, let's get on a little more love. Tell us, Freddie, who is our next guest?
From Anaheim, California, Wally, lovely Linda Dumar.
Linda Dumar, where are you? Come on down, Linda. Oh, oh. That is Linda. Come on, Linda. A little more love for Linda, please. More love. Love for Linda. Linda, come on. Come on, Linda. Come on, Linda. Come on. Oh, you're a princess. Beautiful aquamarine lady. Come on up here. Oh, you just look lovely, Linda. They love you out there, you know.
Thank you, Wally.
Ooh, I'll bet you're just as talented as you are beautiful.
Yeah.
Little candy box hat and everything. Your hands are cold. You want to put them in Uncle Wally's pocket? No. Smarter than Uncle Wally, aren't you? Yes. Okay. So tell me, where are you from, Linda?
Anaheim, California.
Anaheim, California.
Yeah.
That's where Disneyland is. Do you have any little ones? You ever go to Disneyland with your kids or anything?
Yes, I have a daughter, Darcy, and a son, Theron, who is watching today. Oh. With my mother also, and I'd like to say hello to them.
Are you divorced, I hope, huh?
No.
You're not?
No, I'm here with my husband, Melvin, who's right up there.
And what does Melvin do?
Oh, he's a milkman for Rockwood Dairy.
Well, that's great. Without milkmen, hey, how would we get our milk? You know what I'm saying? Anyway, Linda, what are you going to do for us?
I'm going to do a tap dance.
Okay, Linda. Linda Dumar, love you from Anaheim, California. You are on Music Please. Check for $500, or you can choose to go through either gate 1 or 2 and 3 to Easy Street. What would you like to do? Keep the check? She wants to play! Hey! Okay, now, Linda, make your selection wisely, because fame and fortune could lie behind one of these gates. Gate 1, 2, or 3. What do you say? Tick-tock, 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 tick-tock. Two! The young lady's chosen two. Linda Dumar has chosen gate number two. Ready, tell us, what's in gate number two?
Roy Hill's Rutherford II Collection provides American traditional at its best. Features solid pine trim, deep seating, and high backs. Covered in sturdy 100% printed nylon. It retails for $1,307.
That's a lot of stuffing, Linda. Wait! Rolling Thunder! Tiffany!
The finish that resists scratches and stains. And also, Linda, with that new piano, you're going to probably want to have it tuned and take some lessons. So you'll need a tuning fork and some sheet music. So to take care of some of those expenses, take a look at the rest.
Very important. Linda Dumar, do you know what you're going to do with that money?
I sure didn't know what I'm going to do with the money.
Okay, which will it be? The Sentinel or the Landlord?
The Sentinel.
Oh, good.
I'm going to try that again.
The Sentinel is $59,900 and the Landlord's $44,000.
We'll take the Landlord.
And we'll.
I want the goddamn money, and we'll take the goddamn landlord.
So, it's the landlord.
Utility $62, food $210, entertainment $45, doctor bill $60. Well, if we are very, very careful...
Can I get the piano lessons?
I think so.
Great. What about the Girl Scout uniform?
I think we're gonna have to wait on that till next month.
Ah, crap, Ma.
Watch your mouth, Doris.
Is that Daddy? It is Daddy!
Melvin, Melvin, Melvin.
Wow! All right!
Well, what do you think?
Take it back?
You can't take it back. We'll lose our down payment.
Darcy Lee Dumar, get off that ship!
Beautiful, huh?
Oh, take it back, Melvin.
Are you kidding?
Darcy Lee, get away from that car!
Cadillac has a twilight signal. You know when the lights go on the minute you go into a tunnel? It's got an 8-track tape player. It's got... Santa Monica Coast Guard, request weather information. This is the Santana calling the Santa Monica Coast Guard. Come in. Come on in, Santa Monica Coast Guard. What are you doing?
I'm leaving you, Melvin.
I won't ask you back.
Well, I'm never coming back.
I'm not asking you back.
I'm never coming back, and you remember half that house is mine, Melvin.
If you leave, you're not going to get anything.
Melvin, you're a loser!
Don't call me that!
Well, what do you call it? The first time we got a prayer getting ahead, you go out and buy a big fancy boat and a big fancy car.
That stuff is an investment. I told you that.
An investment?
Yeah. Okay, come here. Listen, I want to tell you something. Now, I see that car. That's not just a car, you know. That's our car. I used to see cars like that go by on a highway from Reno to Vegas and from Vegas to Reno all the time when I was working with my dad. They went so fast I could hardly even see them. I used to want one. Now I got one. Understand?
We are poor, Melvin. We're poor.
We're not poor. Broke, maybe. We're not poor. We won the Golden Gate.
I won the Golden Gate.
Well, I'll go. I don't want you to go.
C'est la vie, Melvin.
What's that?
It's French. I used to dream I'd be a French interpreter.
You don't speak French.
I told you it was a dream.
Of course you will.
I love you, Dad.
I got Highline, 2 quarts, garden cottage cheese, 10-pound box of laundry compound.
Sounds right, Melvin. Would you like a nice hot cup of coffee?
Well, not really, ma'am. I got a whole route ahead of me.
It's cold out, Melvin. Yeah. Come on. Don't you want some coffee? Wait. A nice hot cup of coffee.
Well, why not? Excuse me, Mrs. Worth.
Oh, Melva. Melva, Melvin. Get it?
Yes, ma'am. You had a $1,500 note. I got it right here. You got the $1,000 balance. Not now, please, huh? Abe, what are you doing? Milking that thing? You got the $1,000 balance you still owe on the truck. I got $250 on your uniform, which I'll deduct at the next week's salary.
George, pick up on line 12.
That's real cute.
You gotta be Merry Christmas. $90 a week interest? How am I supposed to catch up? I won't do this. I can't do this. All right, man. It's up to you, Melvin.
George Line 12.
What do you want me to get another job or something?
Look, any place you go, you're gonna be working for us.
Jim, what about this insurance plan?
No insurance. Put the pony, yeah. Would you please? Did you sell that boat?
Yeah.
Well, what about the Cadillac?
They took it.
Oh, that's right. They did, didn't they? Well, I don't know what to tell you. You're just gonna have to hustle a little more.
Oh.
Look, we got Ralph over here in Artesia. He can use a little help.
Artesia, that's way across the county. I'll never make it in time. The milk won't even be cold.
Look, did it ever occur to you to get up a little earlier, Melvin?
Hey, I get up at 2:30.
Look, I know it is tough, but you're just gonna have to organize your time a little better. I've told you once, I told you 1,000 times, planning is the name of the game. Just sign it.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Tiki Restaurant is pleased to wish the employees of the Rockwood Dairy a Merry Christmas, or as we say in the islands, Meli Galiki Mugga. Now, relax and enjoy the entertainment portion of the evening featuring the Tiki Sextet.
Listen, I told my wife you sang country, and she's just crazy about country, Mel.
I'll tell her I'm sorry, will you?
Delgado was saying how you was yellow. I said, if Melvin don't want to sing, that's his right.
Yeah, what'd you say?
Well, it ain't what he says, Mel. It's what he don't say, you know what I mean?
All right, you Rockwood people, let's hear a big round of applause for the Tiki Santa Claus Sextet.
As part of tonight's entertainment, old Melvin, Milkman of the Month, Dumas, was supposed to sing us a little song. But I'm afraid, or am I thrilled, that he's chickened out on us.
Hey, I didn't chicken out. You want a song? All right, I got a song.
Oh. Where's your guitar, Melvin? Did they repossess it?
Here, hold this for me, will you?
Oh, let's hear it for Melvin.
I wrote this song to 6 Days on the Road. You know that? 6 Days on the Road?
Yeah, sure, that's fine.
Yeah, that's a Dave Dudley song. Okay. Well, I pulled out of Rockwood, headed down the Santa Ana Freeway. I got my disco wound up, and I guess it's running okay.
So what do you say?
What do you mean?
I'll take care of you, Melvin, till you get back up on your feet again. I got my kid's child support money saved up.
You got a kid?
I got 2 kids.
Oh.
Now listen, Melvin, I got a cousin up in Utah, lost his lease on a gas station. We run it right. We got $1,000 a month clear. Now I have been waiting for this moment, and the moment is now.
Is that net?
Don't you come swinging your dick around my cashier's office.
Bonnie,
no more.
You're a Mormon girl. You talk like that?
You bet your ass.
Oh. Mm. Well, when do we leave?
Tonight.
Thank you.
Parade.
Yes, I understand. Yes, of course. Yes, I'll give him a message. Okay. Okay, yes. Goodbye. He's not going to deliver the gas on Monday unless he gets a check.
Well, let's give him one.
A check.
Well, he's not going to give us gas till we give him a check. We'll give him a check.
Yeah, but our check's no good.
Yeah, I know, but, you know, it's Easter weekend. I might be able to pump about 1,000 gallons, and by Monday it'll be good. What's that? Howard Hughes guy? Hey, I remember I told you to pick that guy up in the desert?
Oh, yeah, yeah. He told me it was Howard Hughes.
A number of tests of his huge Boeing Stratoliner. You look like that, though.
Mom, what are we going to eat? I'm starving. Yeah, what are we going to eat?
There was only one vessel admitted to the test area to act as a fireboat and a platform. What are we having anyway, hon?
Bell peppers.
Yeah. Wouldn't wonder, raised her nose off of the water with ease that no one except Howard Hughes expected.
Hello, Melvin.
Hi. How you doing?
All right.
Can I help you?
Yeah. Some cigarettes.
Oh, cigarettes. What kind you want?
Camels.
Camels, okay. Well, that's a man's cigarette. You probably walk a mile for these. Nowadays, they want long ones and filters and, you want some matches?
Yeah. Charlie.
Well, the matches are free.
Cigarettes.
Oh, that's a buck. It's
buck?
Wait, let's see. Camel's 50 cents.
50 cents. You need to, get down to Las Vegas, Melvin. How do I get out of here?
Oh, see that right there by the lake, that interstate, that's 15. I'll take you right into Vegas.
I was talking to this guy. He said if I take, I believe it was 89 and 60, south and across the line.
Listen, I'll be with you in a minute. Okay?
Guess 15's the best bet.
Good night, Melvin. Bonnie! Bonnie!
Yeah? What?
I gotta go into town for a little while. Take care of everything, will you?
Yeah.
I'll be back.
Okay. Bye.
Oh, my God.
Council of Years.
Gotta talk to you about some square business right now. Okay, let's face it, Melvin. It's gonna be a while before we're gonna see any of this dough, right? So we gotta try to capitalize on it while we're hot. And they watch on Merv Griffin. But the best dollar offer so far comes from a t-shirt manufacturer. Let me tell you, it's a wipe, yeah. What do you think? It's kinda cute, isn't it? Well, anyway, think about this. So many things a press conference.
What?
You got a press conference. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to meet Mr. Melvin Dumar, his wife Bonnie, their children, his attorney Dwayne Edwards. Now, I want to tell you up front, I don't want any litigation questions. Questions only on the basis of the will. Everybody understand that? No litigation questions. First question.
Mr. Dumar, Howard Hughes Company, the Summa Corporation, claims that this smell is a
fraud. No litigation questions.
Did you really believe the man you picked up in the desert was Howard Hughes?
How good is your memory?
Well, I don't know. He said he was Howard Hughes.
He
looked like an old bum.
Howard Hughes was
well, neat, you know, like healthy. This guy was sick. This guy, his hands were all wrinkled up.
Melvin, did you ever think a dream like this could come true?
Yeah, well, you know, when you dream about something, it's no problem, but.
Melvin, everybody in this country thinks you're lying. How does that make you feel?
You understand? He was hurt.
Maybe he thinks I say all the right. I didn't write the will. I don't know anything about the will.
And I'm really pleased that he is going to inherit that $156 million. Is that right? I sure hope that when he gets it, though, that he remembers he owes the Rockwood Dairy here $4,500.
What kind of a guy was Melvin to work with?
Oh, he was a fine man, a good worker. As a matter of fact, he was Milkman of the Month.
$2.
You remember me, don't you, Melvin? I was with you.
Huh?
We were all together. You, me, and Howard. But it was me that gave him that quarter.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you're the one.
That's right.
Are you all right?
Oh, yeah, sure, I'm all right. How you doing? How's Farron? How's Darcy?
Oh, well, Melvin, she is so proud.
Yeah? Hey, it's all right. Listen, she's not having any trouble with school because of this issue.
No, don't worry about it. Melvin, Howard Hughes, huh?
Yeah, what do you think about that?
I think it's amazing.
Listen. I gotta go.
Say hi to the kids.
Goodbye, Mel.
Goodbye, Linda.
Why did you deliver the will to the church?
I was afraid.
What were you scared of?
I was worried about what might be inside.
Why was that frightening?
I don't know. Can you give me
one reason on earth why this strange man would leave that will with you, Melvin Dumar?
Well, I don't know. You know, I've been trying to figure that out myself.
And did you come up with an answer?
No, I didn't.
Melvin, isn't it true you can't come up with an answer because it never happened that way? Please stand up. Face the judge. Place your hand on the Bible. Raise your right hand. Do you swear in the name of God that this story about how you received this will is true?
I do.
Well, Melvin, if it meant eternal damnation in hell, Would you still say it just happened that way?
It's the truth. Of course I would say that. Melvin, turn your chair around and face me, please.
Yes, yes.
Melvin, are you lying?
No, sir.
Well, Melvin, I want you to know that there is a still, small voice that many people are blessed with that tells them when the truth is being spoken. It's been said, what doth it profit a man if he gain the whole world, yet lose his soul? Now, if you're lying, Melvin, which you are in my opinion, your soul may be in jeopardy, but that's not really what I'm concerned with right now, Melvin. I'm concerned with your hide. Because if I find that you're lying before this court, I'll make it a special duty to have a piece of your hide. I'll direct the district attorney to bring a criminal prosecution against you. And I'll make it my special project that if you're convicted, I will recommend that you do time in prison. And I want you to know that the Nevada State Prison is no country club like at Gabb's local jail or wherever it was you served time. If you're lying, you go straight to Nevada State Prison. All right, Melvin?
You bet. Your Honor.
Brother Dumar, I want the truth. Where did this so-called will come from?
Some man brought it by the station where I was working. He left it there.
Well, what are you going to persist in giving the answers that were elicited from you this morning, say?
Yes, sir.
Do you know who wrote the will?
No, I don't.
Did you in any way participate in the preparation of the will?
No, sir.
I've done my best, gentlemen.
Melvin, you did it. On July 6th, they're going to determine the validity of the will. Like he says, it's the only will we got. That plus the positive testimony by the handwriting experts. I think the will's going to be admitted to probate. You're going to get your inheritance.
You think so?
Of course, it's going to be a long, long road. We won the first battle, I can tell. The T-shirt people called again. Look, they're worth an easy $15,000. What do you say?
No, I don't think so, man.
You can use the cash.
What's the matter? You want to get paid?
No, it's just they started paving the freeway today down from the gas station. In 2 weeks, you're going to be pretty lonely up there.
Don't worry about me. I'll be all right.
You won, Mel.
Then what are you so worried about?
I just hope you don't have any illusions. They're going to fight it through every court they can. I mean, the relatives, summa. Meanwhile, the government will be taking out taxes. The state will be taking out taxes. Lawyers taking out legal fees. I mean, money's going to be siphoned off.
Yeah, listen, I've known that since I first found it, Will.
What do you mean?
I mean, you think that Melvin Dumar is going to get $156 million or anything like it? Howard Hughes sang Melvin Dumar's song. That's what happened. He sang it. He was funny. Yeah, he sang it. Santa's souped up sleigh. Let's see.
Sorry.
That's okay. It gave me a chance to get him fed. You sure you want to do this?
Kidding? See my kids? Get them up there with some fresh air?
Oh, yeah.
Go in the back seat. I got some comic books. There's a little toy in there for Farron.
You're not gonna hassle me when I want him back at the end of the summer, are you?
Yeah, my word.
That's what I'm afraid of.
Oh, come on.
You know, Bonnie sure is gonna have her hands full this summer.
How about letting me drive?
You?
I'm a darn good driver.
You haven't driven since they put out the Hudson.
I'm a darn good driver, I'll bet you. My cares and woe, here I go, singing low, bye-bye, blackbird. Where somebody waits for me, sugar sweet, so is she, bye-bye, blackbird. No one here can love or understand me. Oh, what hard luck stories they all. So won't you make my opinion and let me learn? I'll be home late tonight, blackbird. Thank you.
increasing tonight, becoming easterly tomorrow.
He had the blood, and there never was a horse like the Tennessee Stud.
Oh, man. Santa called his elves together to soup up his old sleigh, so Rudolph and the other reindeer could rest on Christmas Day. He's got a million miles to travel and to do it in one day. Oh, that's because old Santa Claus has a souped-up Santa get you some help.
No, no, doctor.
Yeah, this is down, 3 miles up the road. Yeah.